Okay, everyone. This stuff is really freaking dry. It's so boring. And it's hard. Well, it's not hard, but there's a lot of stuff to remember. So pay close attention, and I'm really sorry if I start to drone after a while. I almost put myself to sleep just looking at my notes here. Okay, so first things first. When you convert a number to IEEE 754, you have three sections. This first section here will always be one bit, so just one number, and it's going to be your sign, so either negative or positive. This next bit is called the exponent, and it varies in length, so I'll talk about that in a second. And this last part is called the fraction. Some people call it the significand, some people call it the mantissa. I'm probably going to call it the fraction. It's a little confusing, but there's three names for it. I wasn't the one who invented it, so that's just how it is, I guess. Now, recall that the sign of a binary number can be determined by its most significant bit, which is here, right? So when we have a negative number, our sign will be 1. When we have a positive number, sign will be 0. Now, if you're asked to do a conversion in single precision, that's also 32-bit, so your total number will be 32 bits in length. Or you could be asked to do it in double precision, which would really suck because that's really long, because that is 64 bits. Oops, my 4 kind of messed up there. Now, in 32-bit, your exponent section of your final number will be 8 bits long, and its bias will be 127 base 10. So I'll talk about bias in a second. Now, if you're dealing with 64 bits, your exponent is going to be 11 bits, and your bias is going to be 1023, again in base 10. So now your fraction length is just going to be what's left. So 32 bits, that's obviously 32 minus 9, 1 for the sign, 8 for the exponent. So that leaves us with 23 bits for the fraction. Now, 64 bits, we're left with 52. So those are our lengths. All of my examples here will be 32-bit length single precision or whatever, because 64 is just way too long. Okay. I'm going to cut out for a second and write out a question. So we're converting negative 5.75 using IEEE 754. So the very first step is converting negative 5.75 into regular binary. Recall that we have a negative here. So we will have a negative here, and that 5 in binary is 1, 0, 1. So now we have to convert 0.75. So we have 0.75 here, and we're converting it to base 2, which is binary, so we multiply this by 2. We'll end up with 1.5. Okay, so now we truncate the 1, we end up with 0.5 times 2 again is just 1.0. So we truncate the 1 again, we end up with 0.0 times 2, which is just 0. We look at our little table from top to bottom, and we end up determining that our decimal point here is 1, 1, 0. And that is in base 2. The next step is to shift our dot in our binary number here up to the front of the very first one that we encounter, so the leftmost one. Here we can see that in the number 101, it's right here. And then we just tack on our decimal again. So this form is called a 1.FFF form or whatever. And the F stand for float. Floating point, that's it. Because the point can float. That's, I guess, maybe probably why it's called that. And of course, again, this is in base 2. We have to remember how many shifts we made. So we see that here, that's where our dot is in front of the 101. So that means it was here, and we shifted it two numbers to go here. So we're going to assign that number 2, 2 shifts. And we're going to put that in the variable p. So now that p variable here is equal to 2. And we have to remember that for step 3. And this is where that bias number I was talking about earlier comes in. Our exponent section is equal to the bias plus p. So since we're doing this in single precision, our bias is 127 and our p is 2, which means that our exponent is 129. Now we know that 128 in binary, so 128 in base 10 is equal to 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4 in base 2. Oops. So if we have 129, all we're doing is just adding 1. So that means that our exponent is going to be 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. So all I did was I converted our 129 into regular binary, and that is our exponent value. So we're just about done here. The last and final step is to just put everything together. So we have our sign, it's right here, it's a negative. So that means we have a 1 at the start of our number. And I'm gonna leave some pretty hefty spaces just to show you guys where everything comes in. We have our exponent, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. And then finally, we add in our floating point type thing, which is only this part. That's very important. Please remember that. You're kind of truncating the 1. You're just forgetting about it. So 0, 1. We got 3 ones, and then a 0. But now, since we're doing it in single precision, this number has to be 32 bits in length. We don't have 32 bits. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 bits. So that means we have to add zeros just until we hit our 32-bit mark. Okay, so that is our final answer. That number in step 4 is negative 5.75 base 10 converted to IEEE 754 format. So stay tuned for an example follow-up video. I'm going to be changing an IEEE 754 number back into decimal, so kind of like back conversion. So thank you for watching. Hopefully that helped out. Feel free to suggest ideas for new videos and leave questions in the comments. And happy studying.